Hi friends, first of all, I welcome you in the FY BCom class as a senior student, and I am Mrs. Rowley US. I am here with a paper Business Communication Part 1st, Mumbai University Semester 1st. Today, I want to share the syllabus of our paper, that is Business Communication Part 1st, Mumbai University Semester 1st. Today, I want to share the syllabus of our paper, that is Business Communication. Now, our paper, that is Business Communication Part 1st, is divided, has modules or units, and that units have 4 parts: theory of communication, obstacles to communication in business world, business correspondence, and language and writing skills. Now see that in theory of communication, we will see the concept of communication. Now, what is mean by concept of communication? For understanding the term communication, it means that what is mean by communication, the definitions of communications, there are so many definitions of communications given by experts. Then how the communication takes place, the need of communication, feedback, emergence of communication as a key concept in the corporate and global world. Then channels and objectives of communication. Channels means madhyame, and objectives of communication. Now, what are the channels of communications? That is formal and informal channels. Then vertical communication, horizontal communication, diagonal communication, and grapevine communication. In vertical communication, horizontal communication, and diagonal communication, we will see that how the communication, because in each communication, business communication or any institution, we will see that the hierarchy system. In hierarchy system, we will see there is some superior, there is some subordinate, and in between that communication takes place, that it is necessary to study this type of communication. In objectives of communication, information, advice, order and instructions, persuasion, motivation, education, warning and boosting the morale of employees. These are the objectives of communication, and we will see as a basic part of this part. Then methods and modes of communication. In methods and modes of communication, we will see the methods. Now, what are the methods of communication? The verbal and non-verbal communication. Now, verbal and non-verbal communication means what? Verbal means words. It means that the communication that takes place with the help of the words, that is called verbal communication. And in non-verbal communication means we will study the communication that takes place without the words. It means that it includes the pictures, the posters, the signs, the symbols. That is called as non-verbal communication. So that we will study here. Characteristics of verbal communications and characteristics of non-verbal communications. Business etiquettes. In modes, we will study telephone and SMS communication 3. That is general introduction to telegram and fax. Computers and e-communication, video and satellite conferencing. So that is the first unit of our syllabus, theory of communication. Students, I want to tell you here that this paper gives you a best score. Our next unit is obstacles to communication in business world. Now, what is mean by obstacles? Obstacles means the problems in communication, or what difficulties we will face during communication, that we will see here. In that, problems in communication and barriers to communication. physical, semantic, language, socio-cultural, psychological barriers, ways to overcome the barriers. For example, I want to give you here one example as a language barrier. Barrier means what? Difficulties or problems in the communication. Suppose there are two persons, Marathi person and Tamil person. For communication, these two persons know each other's language. That Tamil person knows Marathi and Marathi person knows Tamil. But if they don't know each other's language, they cannot communicate because Tamil person does not know Marathi and Marathi person does not know Tamil. So that is the barrier between these two persons, that is Tamil person and Marathi person. As like the others, barriers, that is physical, semantic, socio-cultural, psychological, that we will study here. And also we will see how to overcome these barriers. Then listening. Listening is the most important in communication because without listening we cannot answer or we cannot communicate. So importance of listening skills, cultivating good listening skills. Introduction to business ethics. In introduction to business ethics we will study the concept and interpretation, importance of business ethics. Personal integrity at the workplace, business ethics and media, computer ethics, corporate social responsibility, surrogate advertising, patents and intellectual property rights, dumping of medical or e-waste, human rights violations and discrimination on the basis of gender, race, caste, religion, appearance and sexual orientation at the workplace, piracy, insurance and child labor. In the third unit, that is business correspondence. In business correspondence, we will see all types of letters. That business correspondence is divided into two parts, that is theory of business letter writing and personal correspondence. We know that the parts of letter writing, then structure of letter writing, layouts. In layouts we will see various forms of the layouts, in which type of we can write the letter, that is full block form, modified block form, semi block form, principles of effective letter writing, principles of effective email writing also. In parts we will see the 8 parts of letter writing. Students, we know that in the 12th standard we have seen the parts of the letter, that is sender address, that is the particular place of sender address. Then we write down the date. The date is the part of letter writing. Then receiver address. Then subject, reference, salutation, body of the letter, signature box, complimentary clause. So each this part has a specific place. Personal correspondence. Personal correspondence means letters. Statement of purpose, that is SOP. Job application letter and resume. Letter and acceptance of job offer, letter of resignation, etc. And our last unit, that is language and writing skills. In language and writing skills, we will see the various types of paragraph writings. Students, we will study, or our paper is business communication. So in business world, we want to use so many commercial terms. And that commercial terms we will study in this topic. How to write paragraph writing, develop an idea, using appropriate linking devices, etc. Cohesion and coherence, self-editing, etc. You have to adopt some activities also. That is listening comprehension, remedial teaching, speaking skills. In speaking skill, you want to study presenting a news item, dialogue and speeches. Paragraph writing. In paragraph writing, we will study prepare of the draft, revision and self-editing, rules of spelling. Reading comprehension. In reading comprehension, we will see analysis of text from the field of commerce and management. So, up to this, we have seen that the syllabus of our paper, that is business communication part first. Okay, so I hope that you have understood the syllabus of our paper pattern. Thank you.